Yo, this man is in here passing all kind of gas. So what's up, you guys? It's Marcella Jacquette, and I'm coming back at you guys with another Social Butterfly Saturday video. Look both ways before you cross my mind, and shout out to the conversation because you guys know I have a lot of it. I'm gonna be talking about this dude that I hung out with and how I found out one of my biggest pet peeves. We were hanging out, I met him where I usually go skating at. He came up to me while I was skating and, you know, we exchanged numbers. We ended up hanging out. I thought he was pretty cool. And so we started hanging out. It was probably like maybe the third time that we hung out. Maybe the third or the fourth time like we hung out. I was at his apartment. We had ate some food. We were just like kicking it, watching TV and stuff. And he goes in the bathroom and he used the bathroom. And I didn't think nothing of it. But like in the room, it was like pitch silent. The computer just went completely quiet because like what we were watching went off. So I hear him in the bathroom just, y'all, passing all kind of fucking gas. And I know y'all might think I'm shallow and say he was in the bathroom, but I just can't get with it. I just couldn't get with it. Anyway, he's in the bathroom and this is how it went basically, like, shit, fuck. And I was sitting there, y'all. Like, I wanted to just vanish. It was, I wanted to just vanish. It was out of control. So I'm sitting there, I'm looking at my phone, and every time I hear him do that, my face is just like, shit, fuck. Oh, shit. So I'm texting my homegirls, and I'm like, y'all, this man is in here passing all kind of gas. Like, how do I get out of here? Help me. So my homegirls hit me back like, who? And I'm like, the person. Say the person's name. I'm not gonna say it here because I'm already embarrassed about telling this fucking story out here. The shit got me more embarrassed and it didn't even happen. Like, I wasn't even the one in the bathroom. So he comes out of the bathroom and he's like all over me and shit. And he's like, hey, come outside and smoke with me. And I'm just like trying to play it off because like I didn't want to seem shallow, but like I'm dying on the inside. So I'm just like, nah, it's okay. Like, you know, just go out and smoke, you know. I don't smoke, so he likes me to stand out with him when he smokes. But I was like, nah, I'm comfortable. I done already got comfortable. Just go ahead and, you know, go ahead and you go. So he's like, nah, come outside with me. And I'm like, no, you know, it's cool. I'm comfortable. Just hurry up, go outside, do your thing. So finally he goes outside on the balcony porch and I'm sitting here like trying to figure out like how the fuck I'm gonna get out of here because I gotta go. Like, there's no way I can stay here and feel comfortable. So my homegirl hit me up like the night before, either the night before or two nights before, and was like, girl, you need to come get me. She was at this event, she was ready to go, she was upset, but I was asleep so I didn't get her message. So the next day I was texting her like, hey girl, if anything else happens, y'all come get you. So it popped in my head that I could just use that. So I pack all my shit up, get my computer and everything. And he comes back in and he's like, oh, hey, you know what's going on? I was like, oh, you know, my homegirl, you know, she got some shit going on. I gotta go get her. Like, I gotta go get her. I know my homegirl. I know she's upset. He's like, oh, okay. All right. She good? I was like, I don't know. You know, I really don't know. I'm hoping that she's okay. Just, I know my friend, so, you know, I just gotta go get her or whatever, because it might turn into some crazy shit, I don't know. So, y'all, my acting skills was, like, top-notch, okay? Like, I had to be, because I had to get up out of there. So I got my shit, and he's like, you want me to walk you to your car? In my mind, I'm like, nah, you know, I got it. So we start walking to my car. I wanted to just fly away, y'all, and just get away from him, but he ain't know that. So, get in the car, I leave, and yeah, I didn't want him to think like I just left, so I had to play it all the way to the end. Get to my house, set the alarm for like 3 hours, cause like where my friend was and where we were was like 3 hours away. So I set my alarm, it goes off like 3 hours later, and I just wake up and text him like, hey, we made it home. I know I'm shitty, but like that was hard for me, that was too hard. So the next day I like go to my mama's house and I'm chilling with her or whatever. And I'm telling her like, ma, like he farted and like, I just can't get with it. Like, I just don't feel the same about him. Like, it's just too much for me. And she was like, well, you need to say something to him. And I was like, I want to, I just don't know what to say. Like, I don't know what I should say. So I'm on the phone and I'm gonna show y'all what I text. So I text him and I'm just like, hey, are you feeling better today? And he was like, yeah, I feel fine. What about you? And I was like, well, my stomach wasn't hurting last night. I was worried that your stomach was bothering you. He was like, oh yeah, it was, I needed to adjust my eating schedule habit or something like that. Look at my face. Anyway, so I'm just like, next time just let me know you need some space because it made me feel uncomfortable. He was like, what did? What made you feel uncomfortable? I was like, fuck it. I'ma just tell you. I heard you in the bathroom passing gas and it made me feel uncomfortable. I just met you, so it's weird for me. He was like, oh yeah, my bad. I apologize. That would not happen again. I understand that and I'm very sorry about that. Next time I will say something in advance. If I'm not feeling well, please forgive me. I normally never have gas at all. It was weird for me too. Cannot say sorry enough for that. I was like, it's okay, I appreciate you being so understanding. So he was like, of course, I know you would do the same. So I'm sitting here, like I had to say something because knowing me, like I just will look at you so differently. And even after we had that conversation, y'all, I still wasn't over it. Like we had the conversation, it was supposed to be over. And I still was feeling some type of way. You know, it's really not like me to be faking the funk around people. I'm usually pretty like honest, but like that, like y'all, that was totally, it's too much for me, okay? I'ma just let you know that now. It was way too much for me. And I don't feel ashamed that it was too much for me because I just, everybody's different. Everybody sees things differently. Like I am just one of those people ever since I was a little girl that I just, passing gas, farting, all that kind of stuff. Yes, I do it. Yes, it's normal. But am I comfortable with it? Nah. Now, in different spaces, yes. Like, there's a time and a place for everything. Like, if I fuck with you on a shrimp that you my man, I don't care. I'm gonna make a joke out of it. Like, I may pass gas in front of you, laugh about it, whatever. I'm gonna always say, excuse me. But I might laugh about it. I did feel like he was mature for handling it the way he did because I think a lot of guys, and even my guy friends, like, I tell them the story and they're just like, man, hell no, you tripping. And I'm like, I don't give a fuck. I don't like that, you know? That's just me. I don't like that, so I'm not gonna front for anybody. But anyway, that's the story. Tell me in the comment section below what y'all's pet peeves are. What are some shit that dudes do that y'all are just like, uh-uh, I can't deal with it. I'm not gonna deal with that. You might never see me again if you do that shit. Let me know in the comment section below. For my old subscribers, if you haven't already yet, click the bell next to the subscribe button. That way you can get notifications for when I upload my videos. And shout out to all you other folks out there that have already clicked the bell and get my videos every time I post them. For my new subscribers, and I know you guys are my new subscribers because you guys are just that cool, to go ahead and click that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell as well, just so you guys can get notifications for when I'm uploading videos. Other than that, I will see you guys in my next video. And don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. All right, guys, see you next time.